Every journey has a beginning and an end. And while most are exciting, some can be less than memorable. In my 7 years as the ag teacher and FFA advisor at Madison County Middle School, I got to experience a lot of first memories and experiences and journeys. And perhaps none of them have been as action-packed, energy-filled, and passionate as your next speaker's. He has always had a drive and a desire to want to know more and really understand the why. And I know that those things have served him well as he has served you this year as your state FFA president. Ian has always had a passion for knowing more about his fellow FFA members and helping them find their why.
I have watched my brother grow up as a person through his years in the FFA. He has taught me so much from the dreams and goals that he has accomplished. Ian has set an example for me throughout my life and will continue to be my role model. He is the type of leader and person that I strive to be. I have watched Ian find his why while pursuing his dreams in the FFA. And now, it is my pleasure to introduce you to my big brother and your 2023-2024 State FFA President, Mr. Ian Heath.
What do you do when things go wrong? How are you able to achieve success, and who helps you get there? How are you pushing yourself to be better than you were the day before? These are the questions that I often ask myself when evaluating any situation that I am in. This afternoon, these are the questions that I ask you. No matter what I'm feeling at a specific time in life, I always turn back to these questions. Whether I'm having a fantastic day, like I just passed a test, the radio was playing all the right songs, and someone told me they loved my outfit. Or I'm on the other side of the spectrum, having a not-so-good day, like beating myself up for the little things that happen in life. Through it all, I come to the realization that this is something we all face. Good days and bad days, ups and downs, but knowing that if we try our hardest to keep an optimistic attitude, we are making the best of every situation. My favorite TV show in the entire world is a show called Ted Lasso. If you would like to watch it yourself, you can check it out on Apple TV. Ted Lasso is the story of two American football coaches that quit their job after winning a national championship back in 2019. They then decide to put their talent towards coaching a professional soccer team in England. Knowing nothing about the sport of soccer, the two coaches would go on to have a very unsuccessful first season. However, Coach Lasso kept a very interesting perspective on life. There's a player on Coach Lasso's team named Sam Obasanya, and he is from Nigeria. Now, Sam is one of the best players on the team and holds himself to a very high standard. And so one day the team is out at practice, and Sam makes a mistake, and one of his teammates kind of makes fun of him for it. Now, Sam immediately starts beating himself up for that tiny mistake. Coach Lasso saw this and calls Sam over to the sideline and says to him, "Sam, do you know what the happiest animal on earth is?" "No," says Sam. "It's a goldfish. And do you know why?" And without giving Sam time to answer, he says, "It's because they have a 10-second memory. Be a goldfish, Sam. Be a goldfish." Now, this may seem like just a funny concept that Coach explained to Sam, but there's more to it than just a quick laugh. You see, what Coach is talking about is that mistake that Sam just made. He's implying that Sam can dwell on it for about 10 seconds, then forget about it and move past it. I will be the first to tell you, I am not perfect. Never have been, never will be. I have bad days and imperfect moments just like all of you. However, the realization that I've come to is that sometimes it's okay to think for just a second about the imperfect moment you just had and how you can learn from it, but then you and I both need to forget it and move past it. After watching this in the show, thinking about it and applying it to my life, I have named it the goldfish mentality. Bad circumstances can arise at any time or place, and sometimes it may not seem like good timing. But when it does stop for a second, be a goldfish and keep moving. I have worked to embody this goldfish mentality in all that I do in my life. Throughout my time in the FFA, I've had to forget about the small inconveniences and keep striving for success. Sometimes I had someone pushing me to do this, and other times it was because I knew I had to work harder. During my senior year, there was a moment when I was not applying myself like I should, and I had someone there to help keep me on track. One day, I was sitting in Mr. Pedraza's fifth period poultry science class. Now, Mr. P, as we called him, was one of my FFA advisors that helped me prepare to run for state office and for many other events in the FFA. And so here I am. I'm sitting in his class. I finished my classwork for the day, so I decided it would be a good idea to pull my phone out and play a game instead of doing something beneficial. Since this is what I decided to do, Mr. Pedraza saw this and very quickly approached me with a question that would change the way I think about the mentors in my life. Shouldn't you be studying for state office instead of playing games on your phone? Now, granted, this may seem like just another one of those times when one of my teachers got on to me for being on my phone. But it's so much more than that. This is proof that all Mr. P wanted was the best for me. It took me months after this interaction to realize that I am so blessed to have so many mentors that have pushed me along the way. How often do we take a second just to thank those mentors? Admittedly, it's not as much as it should have been for me. It's also important to remember that you will never have just one mentor. For example, in middle and high school, I had 9 different ag teachers that helped guide me in a multitude of ways. Not to mention, one mentor I live by every day is the one that says that we are fearfully and wonderfully made to achieve anything that we want. To each of my mentors in the room today, and you know exactly who you are, thank you for helping make me the fearless, faithful, helpful man I am on stage today. The relation here is that no matter who your mentor is or how many you have, they have helped you in ways that you will later understand. While each of these people have played a vital role in my success, it's important to remember that they won't always be around to guide like they did before. Throughout my time in the FFA, I've been intentional about getting rid of the things that were possibly taking away from my main goals. The reality of life is people will come and go in your life, and that is perfectly okay. I like to think of it as a rocket. When a rocket launches into space, it has boosters that propel it to a certain point. But once the rocket reaches a certain altitude, the boosters fall off, and the rocket keeps going to its destination. As you go home from convention this afternoon, thank the people that have and do pour into you the most. While we talked about the goldfish mentality and forgetting about the things that may be difficult or weighing you down, when it comes to your mentors and the people that helped you achieve success, never forget them. Going through different experiences on this earth, in school, in the FFA, in every other endeavor you make achieve, achieving success never has to stop. You never have to stop setting goals and reaching them time and time again. Always strive to push yourself to be better than you were the day before. Now, this doesn't just happen by snacking on some Lay's chips and watching The Office. It will take hard work and dedication to get there. Louis Cavalli has a famous quote that says, "Lazy people do a little work and think they should be winning. But winners work as hard as possible and still worry if they're being lazy." This quote is a true testament to this day that we live in. Now, the focus doesn't always have to be to win a trophy or a title. In fact, success has many faces. But measure yourself by how hard you've worked to be better than you were the day before. If you can, write this quote down. I say this every morning before I get up to start my day. Good, better, best. Never let it rest until my good is better and my better is best. As many times as I've said these words, they still impact me daily as I say them. I pray that they would impact you as well. As I sit and I reminisce on these words, I realize that no journey is perfect and obstacles will get in your way trying to stop you from the end goal, but that if you can be strong, get past it, and forget about it, you will make it further than you ever thought possible. Serving as your state president this year has been the greatest blessing of my life. To meet members from all across the state, hear your stories, and to connect over agriculture has been truly life-changing. I know each of you have embraced each of the opportunities I've talked about tonight because I've seen it firsthand. Each of you works harder to be more competitive in your CDE or LDE. I have seen chapters go absolutely nuts over their advisors and teachers for helping them. And finally, each of these people on screen embrace the goldfish mentality each and every day. Some are mentors, some are members, some are friends of mine, some are family. As my time in this jacket draws to a close, Georgia FFA, I encourage you to push yourself as hard as possible to be better than you were the day before. Think every minute about what it takes to be successful. Thank the people that have and do impact you to get you successful. But most importantly, I hope that you will remember Ted Lasso's words through the hard times and the challenges. Have a 10-second memory and just be a goldfish. Did you make a man?
The presence you bring into any room is great, but your love for a good air-fried chocolate chip cookie and a Philly cheesesteak might just be greater. Our team has come to learn that if you ever go missing, we are more than likely to find you in a pig barn, swinging away at a golf course, or cheering on Texas A&M's football team. Throughout the year, I've witnessed your love for God grow as you have poured into thousands of members throughout the state. Your commitment and dedication have allowed you to be a great leader to our team and our organization. Ladies and gentlemen, get on your feet for your 2023-2024 State FFA President from the Madison County FFA.